So, in today's life, people start businesses in many ways. They can ask for a loan, they can ask for money from family and friends, or they can save up to start a business themselves. But there's a certain group of people who practice start a business methods, but they use it in a different way. So, a group of people starting a business in today's world, of course, start a business is not something new. It's a method that has been used for a very long time, but the system called start a business didn't exist. So, in today's life, you find that a group of 10 people can can come together and raise $1,000 and start a business. A group of 20 people can come together, each brings $1 million and they save $10 million and they start a business. So it is not something new. These are people, a group of 20 people come together, a group of 10 people come together to start a business. So it is not something new what Startup Business is trying to do, but Startup Business is trying to make it what we call commercial. Most people come together to start a business, but majority of them, they don't pay licenses, they don't pay taxes, they don't follow a certain system that is required to start a business. So you'll find that many groups of people came together to start a business, but majority of them, those businesses failed. And it's because of the system they used. Find 10 guys, come together and say, let's start a business. There are no agreements signed, they just do it through word of mouth. They say, let's start a business, you guys will take 10% each, let's start that business. There are no responsibilities shared in that business. So you find that there are no agreements signed, there's no signing of agreements. And then we have something that's called, there's no signing of agreements, number one. Number two, there is no sharing of responsibilities. Nobody knows what is their function in that business. Someone just comes up with the idea, let's start a business. They remove money. They say, you give me some certain amount of money at the end of the month or at the end of the year. So they don't really share responsibilities. Maybe one of them has the ability to market the business much better. Because someone has just come with an idea, let's start a business. They put all the responsibility to that one person. Then they don't sign an agreement. They just agree with themselves. So you find that after some time, there will be a lot of conflicts. Because number one, there will be stealing of money in that business, lack of trust. Number two, there is no sharing of responsibilities. People just start a business, they walk away, they leave the responsibility to one person. They are the ones supposed to market, they're supposed to look for customers, they're supposed to sell the product. So, in today's world, start a business is in existence, but it's not being practiced as it would have been practiced if the start a business app and the start a business organization existed. But start a business, what happens when a group of 10 people come together, they say they want to start a business? First, they meet up. And then number two, when these people meet up, most of them do not know each other, so there will be no history relating to how this person will function, there's no judgment. So group of 10 people come together, meet up, sign agreement, give the money to the startup business employee, start a business for them. At the end of the month, they come for the money at the bank, and they are given the money according to their share. So startup business is a system that enables a group of people to start a business. It is true, start a business already exists. People come together, friends come together to start a business. But what if people who are not friends and they want to start a business, how would they meet together and start a business? You can't go stop people in town asking them if they want to start a business. It's not possible. But start a business already exists among friends, among work colleagues, among governments. But we need more and more people to start businesses together. And that's why we're creating start a business, which is a system that will enable people who don't know each other to start a business together, as well as those who know each other to start a business. So start a business already exists in the society today, but the system doesn't. As I've said, group of people can start a business, majority of them don't work because there are no signed agreements, there's no sharing of responsibilities, there's some judgment, mistrust, disloyalty, disagreements. So a group of people in today's life can come to start a business, but without a system of sharing responsibilities, signing agreements, how money is distributed, how the business is started, the system in today's world will not be as effective as it would be with startup business. So startup business already exists, but this startup business app is one that enables those who already know each other to start a business easily, and those who don't know each other also to start a business easily, by giving them a chance to meet up, sign agreements, share responsibilities, do the business together, share the returns in a fair, much fairer way in order for them to start the business.